Hello guys, it's Ray J, and in this video I will show you how to use your Xbox 360 controller with your PC. First of all, there are two different types of controllers, wired and wireless. For the wired controller, all you have to do is plug a controller into your computer and it will work straight away. However, if it still doesn't work, then click on the link in the description and download the wired drivers. It will be a very simple process, so go ahead and follow the instructions once downloaded. If you have a wireless controller, then you will need to get a wireless receiver which can be plugged into your computer. Microsoft do sell their own wireless receivers, however there are a multitude of third-party receivers which work just as well and are considerably cheaper. For example, Microsoft sell their own one for around £17. If you have the extra money lying around, then I would suggest this as it will work straight away. However, if you want to save some money, then I suggest buying a third-party receiver for around £5 from Amazon or eBay. You'll be able to find the links in the description below. The third-party ones work exactly the same, however you do need to install a few drivers to make them work properly, which I'll show you how to do now. You'll most likely receive a disc of the receiver, but you do not need this. Instead, go onto the link in the description and download the software here. You'll then need to select your operating system from the list. If you're on Windows 7 or above, then Windows 7 will do just fine, as I'm on Windows 10 and have had no problems. If you're unsure if your computer is 32-bit or 64-bit, then go onto Desktop, right-click on this PC or My Computer for previous versions of Windows, and then select Properties. Here you will be shown what version your computer is. As you can see, mine is 64-bit, so I'll be selecting 64-bit from the list. Once you've selected your version, click Download, and when it's downloaded, locate it in your Downloads folder or simply click on the download to run it. Hit Agree, Next, and install the application. Now we need to restart the computer, so let's go ahead and do that now. Once the computer has restarted, go ahead and plug in the wireless receiver. You will notice that Windows attempts to install the driver, but fails. This is fine. Now you want to go to Device Manager. On Windows 8 and 10, go to the bottom left hand corner, and then right click and select Device Manager. If you're on Windows XP, then click Start, right click on My Computer, select Properties, now select the Hardware tab, and then select Device Manager. If you're on Windows Vista, click Start, right-click My Computer, select Properties, then click on Device Manager in the top left corner. If you're on Windows 7, click Start, then click Control Panel, select Hardware and Sound, you will see Devices and Printers, now click on Device Manager below. Now that you're on Device Manager, you will see an unknown device, hover over it and right-click, then select Update Device Drivers. Select Browse My Computer for driver software. Then select Let me pick from a list of device drivers on my computer. Scroll right down to the bottom where you will see Xbox 360 peripherals. Select this and then hit Next. You will want to go down to the bottom and pick the latest driver that is available for you. As you can see, mine is 2015. However, if you do not see 2015, then select 2013 or 2009. Just make sure it is the latest driver that you can see. Now click Next, Yes, and now the driver will have been installed. Now you'll be able to use the receiver, so go ahead and connect the controller and that's it. You can now game using your wireless 360 controller. Not only can you play with one wireless controller, but you also have the ability of being able to connect and play with up to 4 controllers on your computer for multiplayer games, which is a really nice feature. As a side note, sometimes the device may not work, and this is usually because you have previously unplugged the device from the computer and plugged it back in again, and simply it decides not to work. If this is your scenario, then all you have to do is uninstall the driver from Remove a Program and then follow this process all over again. It's really not too bad and it doesn't happen often. If you have any problems or questions, then go ahead and leave a comment and I'll try to help you out as soon as possible. Hopefully this video is useful to you, and if you liked it, then please leave a like, comment or subscribe, as it really does mean a lot. Hope you guys have a great day and thanks for watching. This has been a Ray J.